Hi. I'm very pleased to have the like this exhibition in Paris, and also I want to I want to thank you for inviting this place. Today, I want to explain a little bit my theme of the exhibition. The fleeing architecture. So this theme is probably coming from situation of my office. So now the product of my office is 80% is the foreign country, not in Japan. So I have a lot of different type of the client, that they have a lot of different type of the culture and the value, and also even if the same program, they have the different request. So, and also in the society situation, we can go easy to a lot of place, and also we can connect a lot of person very easily, and also we can accept a lot of different culture, and also different type of the value I can accept. So I think if that is the case, I think that we need to have the more different type of the architecture. So we need to increase the type of the architecture a lot. So I think if we realize this case, I think we need to have the more, we need to increase the type of the architecture. So I think this my exhibition is just a kind of the example of this theme. So today, I will explain about these things by my project. The first project is this is the project to design a place to think about the world peace in Copenhagen, Denmark. This red area is a site. The site is on the sea. The required program is very simple. Just a multi-purpose for playing space, and also just a facility space. So very simple program. So this building is a kind of the meditation space to think about the world peace. So, and also we are thinking of the creator architecture like a cloud as if mist arise from the water. Now, this is a section. The composition of the building is very simple. This part is the office, and this part is the entrance from the quay. This part is the meditation space to think about the world peace. The floor is continue to the inside to the outside. The structure, this is the explanation of the structure. A lot of pillars is come from the bottom of the sea. And also we create the shell structure, and then this shell structure put on these pillars. The seawater comes into the building and create the floor structure. And this is the plan of the bottom of the sea. Bottom of the sea level. The people can access from the quay to the entrance like this. And also people can access from the outside by the boat. This is a section of the part of the building. The visitor is the visitor is can access this building by the boat. The ceiling height is different from the depend on the place. Some part is very nearby the sea surface. Some part is a very high ceiling. The both the concrete wall and the glass wall goes inside 2 meters below the water surface level. And they always sit under the water. This is the grass floor, and then this is the sea surface. The whole structure is sink to the water 2 meters below from the surface of the water. So the surrounding water continues to the inside, but since the water is kept 2 meters below the water surface, so it is completely separated from the surrounding ocean draft. Therefore, the inside water temperature is kept stable. So from the summertime, this window is open, and then the waving is coming from the outside to the inside. But from the beginning of the autumn, we can close this window, and then the sunlight going to the inside like this, and then this water is very stable because the cut from the outside ocean drift. So the sunlight heating keeping in this water. And then the winter time, this hot water makes the warmer the inside this space. So this building doesn't have any air conditioning equipment. Just we are making the structure and also the system of the water keeping system. So this is the elevation drawing. The atmosphere, it looks like the cloud is coming from the ocean surface. The roofscape, it looks like a sea of the cloud. The concrete wall stand on the surface of the water as if they are floating on the ocean. At the perimeter of the building, sink under the sea, the space between white concrete shell and the water surface becomes a new interior environment. The opening at the perimeter of the building remains at a low level. So the height of this wall is less than 1 meter. So the most of the natural sunlight, it's coming from the reflect on the bottom of the sea and then going to the inside. So the brightness of inside is very different from the depend on the time. For example, when the altitude is low during the morning and evening, the sunlight reflect on the surface of the water like this, and then the reflection of the water, the render from the render on the ceiling of the building. This drawing the scenery of the morning, the a lot of sunlight come from the opening. This is the kind of the afternoon. The water is come from the surface of the water. If we close the window of the surrounding of the building, the inside of water becomes like mirrors. A lot of scenery reflect on the surface of the water. In the summertime, we can open the window, and then the surrounding the waves coming to the inside, and then create a various type of the ripples. So the evening, the color of the sunset will reflect on the cloud ceiling. Through this project, I would like to think further about the possibility that architecture as a structure can create a new landscape and a new environment. I want to create a new type of the outside space inside of the building. So I want to create a new environment inside of the building. This is the next project. This is the residential project for the young couple and their children. This house stands in the suburbia of Tokyo. This is the exterior view from front. The facade the made out of two materials. One is a very cheap panel, and another one is a glass. This was a very low budget project. This is a section drawing. The section is very simple. We made a big volume of the space, and then we have some mezzanine space. And also the existing soil is also the exist inside of the building like this. So because the existing ground is left inside of the building, so it is possible to plant various vegetation in the house, and the house itself becomes the little cute garden environment. This is the floor plan drawing. The whole entire space becomes the beautiful garden. The dining table, and also the sink, kitchen cabinet, the shelves, the shoe storage, and the other furniture will be placed in the garden with plants. We propose this house as if we plan a little landscape. This is looks like a photograph of the outside, but this is the inside space. So this is a dining space. Even though this house is located in the middle of the city, it feels like being in the forest. In the garden space, the refrigerator and the kitchen cabinet are also placed as a part of the landscape. It becomes the ambiguous space between inside and outside. This view from the mezzanine, the terrace and the plants grow in the garden, and that it takes off existence of the architecture. In addition, they overlap on the trees inside and outside, and the boundary of the inside and the outside space becomes even more ambiguous. Once the curtain is closed, the green color of the plants appear in the white light. It feels like in the foggy forest. As you walk through the alley in this house, sink can be reached looking through the plant next to the glass window. The dining area can be reached by following the stepping stone in the alley. The stepping stone runs through from the entrance to the dining. This is the view from the dining room. Looks towards the outside street. Compared to the urban environment with the asphalt ground, the inside of this house gives more natural exterior atmosphere with the natural soil. The furniture and the plants mixed up equally in the house. This image shows the dining space from the underneath the mezzanine terrace. The dining area seems to be an outside space. The inside and the outside scenery overlaps each other, and it creates a new environment. This image was taken from the outside and looking inside space. So I think that this project is, I want to create a new type of the environment inside of the building, the same as the previous project. So this is of course this building is of course inside of the urban area, but I want to create a new natural environment inside of the building, and then I want to create a new lifestyle. The those plants in this house sometimes the bloomed flower, and sometimes the change the color of the leaves. You can feel the change of the season inside of this house. This house project is not only fulfill just a living function, And it I want to create a new natural relaxing environment. What I wanted to find for this project was not only new space, but a new environment. The next project is the lecture hall, kind of the visitor center in the historical park located in the outer city of the Amsterdam. The site is very beautiful. There is a beautiful natural park with the countless ponds in the forest. This area is a very wet land, so there is a lot of ponds. Yeah, there is a lot of moss. This is the old villa built in the 19th century. This old villa, the renovation of this villa is a part of the project. And we will design the new lecture hall as an extension of this villa. Inside of this park, there are various types of the paths wired in the park. And the people could enjoy walking around the park. This is the site plan. This is the part of the park. Because this park is historically very important, we cannot change any green area, any ground form, or any building. So it is very difficult to build the architecture inside of this park. Under this condition, we thought about finding the best passage shape from the existing park path and apply onto our architecture planning. When you first look at this drawing, it might be difficult to find the building, but the building is here. So we just are finding the good place for the building in the existing park path. So I just are tracing the existing park path and then make a new plan of the building. So the plan was simply made tracing the existing park path and turn into the inside space. So through this project, we concentrate on thinking of how architecture melts into the existing environment. This is the plan. When you walk around the park, you can find the entrance in the middle of the park path. This is the entrance here. This is the before this area was the existing park path. Now this is the inside of the building, and this is the entrance area. And then you can reach the center of the building, and also you can reach the old villa. This is a model image. The existing park path shapes the building home itself. The old facade was made out of the glass. It is stretched out according to the park path. And this beautiful facade seems endlessly continued to the park. I would like to plan this facility to be a part of the park scenery. So we thought it is important to have the minimum structure support to have the keeping the good scenery. So I want to make a building as transparent as possible. So we propose to use only transparent glass to support the whole building structure. This is the entrance. And the building itself is disappeared in the existing scenery. This is a section of the drawing of the corridor. In order to use the transparent glass as a structure load-bearing wall, we use three layers of the self-standing glass. The outside layer of the glass here, this glass support for the window force. The inside two layers glass here, this glass support for the vertical force. And also, like this, the triangle shape is the work for the prevent the like this horizontal force. As I explained, the glass wall could support the entire building as a structural load-bearing wall, but it also reflects, transmits scenery, and becomes a part of the park. It extends as a beautiful transparent screen into the park. This transparent screen gently divides the area in the park, and it creates a different activity and atmosphere in the historical park. We transform the existing park bus to the architectural space. In the meanwhile, the new landscape will be created around the building. As a result, by having this transparent screen, the new space will appear both inside and outside of the building. Finally, this building appears transparent hedge in the beautiful historical park. The construction, and this is a construction photograph. Like this, the completely transparent structure is built in between space of the existing scenery. This is the photograph of the completed. The roof structure is put on the glass structure. No columns. We can difficult to see the building. Building is here and also here. Sometimes this building reflects the existing scenery and also we can see the outside of different side of the building. The existing scenery and the reflecting scenery coexist and mixed with and also the making the new scenery. The inside the floor level is a little bit lower than the outside, the 1 meter below the existing ground level. So if you can sit down on the chairs, your sea level becomes the same level as the ground. So I want to make some kind of the natural feeling. So I want to make a feeling of the picnic. When you are going to the picnic, so all of the person can sit down the ground. I want to make like this feeling inside of the building. This place, the two glass wall, the connect to the here, and then the glass screen becomes the one screen, and then going to the forest and disappear. This is the entrance from the existing building. This is the photograph when there is some lecture. In the rainy day, a lot of the water drop on the surface of the glass. I want to make a space from the existing scenery. So I don't want to make a shape of the space by the building. I want to create a new space by the in the existing scenery. This is the same function as the park pass. So this is the part of this part, the two glass screen coming together and then making the one glass screen. And also the building disappeared in the existing beautiful scenery. The next project, this is the project to make a new park in the site of the existing hotel. This hotel is located in the north part of Japan. Yeah, this is the aerial photograph of the site. These are existing hotels. Our site is here. The area is 60,000 square meters, and also we are planning to make a new hotel here. Now we are planning to make a new hotel here. So now this is the site of the garden. This is the site of the new hotel. So the area of the new hotel and the new area of the new garden is the mostly same, the 16,000 square meters. The problem is in the regulation, the we can make a building only this area. This area is the existing condition is forest. But the garden area is the existing condition is kind of the grass field. In the regulation, we can make a building here, but we can't make a building here because this is the farmland. So if we make the building here, we have to cut a lot of trees. So we decide all forest here move to this side. So this is the existing the garden, the park site. The existing condition is a grass field. This is the site of the hotel. We decide that this forest move to this site. So the purpose of this project is to reconstruct the existing environment, existing environment element, and then make a new natural environment. The condition of this site was 15 years ago. This site was a rice field, and also more than 100 years ago, this site was the forest. I want to superimpose the history of the existing environment. So I want to overlap the forest environment and also the water environment like a rice field and also the moss landscape. This is the plan. This is the enlarged plan. The gray part is the water pond, and this round is a tree. I plan scenery as if mixed with the pond and the trees each other. This is the detailed drawing of the pond. The upper one is the upper detailed plan. Each pond is connected by the pipes. And also this is the detailed section. This also the showing the this pipe connected the both pond. So the old pond is connected by the pipes, and then the water is come from the next river, and then the flowing the site, and then go back to the existing rivers. And also we are keeping the surface of the water the same level as the existing ground. This drawing is the drawing of each pond. The more than 160 ponds are planted in the site. This is the old list which we plan to move. These are all trees of the next forest. We decide the shape of the old trees. This is the site of the hotel. This is the site of the park. We plan to move the old trees of this site to this area, like this. This is a study model. Concerning the shape of the tree and the shape of the pond, we will create a lot of type of the space in each place. The trees and the pond and a plant at a close distance. So extremely high density of the pond and trees, which does not exist to the in the natural world. Yeah, we studied a lot of studies the place of the trees. Looks very natural. So the basically the very difficult to move the like this big trees. Each the height of the each tree is more than 15 and also 20 meters or something. So basically normally very difficult to move. So the we use like this heavy industrial machine which can move big trees. And there are only two machines in Japan. We use one of those here. So using this machine, we move all trees of the existing forest into the neighbor side, like this. And each tree, the moving the one by one, and make a new forest next of the tree side. This is a construction photograph. We all trees move to the this side, and also we are creating the a lot of pond. Each pond is connecting by the pipes. So this pond is actually like a rivers. As I said before, the water it come from the existing next rivers, and then the water is flowing the old pond, and then coming back to the existing river. So and also that this area is very famous for the moss. So we also the planning to make a surface of this garden by the moss like this. So the site you can walk by the stepping stone, and then you can enjoy the outdoor place. So now the construction is almost finished. This garden will be open this summer. So in this through this project, I want to make a new type of the natural environment by using the existing element of the existing element of the nature, like trees. And also water, and also the moss, the old element that come from the existing one. But we recomposition and then replacement, and then make a new type of the natural environment here. So this is a workshop designed for the university student. It's called Kite Workshop. This university is in the suburb of Tokyo. This is the plan of the entire university. The university site is here. This is the playground. This is the plaza of the university. And this is the site. This is the in-between space of the playground and the plaza. This is a photograph of the roof. The building is a one-story building. The site is the width is 45 meters, and also this side is also 45 meters. The total area is about 2,000 square meters. The four facades of this building are all transparent glass. So this is the image of the forest. I want to create like this space inside of the building. So the important point for me is the layout of the tree in the forest is very difficult to understand why each tree is here and here. So but the problem is I'm thinking the probably so there is some system here, but we cannot see, we cannot understand. But if we are going to the inside of the forest, for example, the camping or something. So in that case, we can find a lot of space in the forest. Some place become the tent area, and also some place become the fire area or something. That we can find a lot of space. So in the forest, we also at the same time we can understand the system of the placement of the forest, and also at the same time that there is a very strict system in the forest, I think. So I want to make a like this. I want to make a building in the like this philosophy. There is no wall inside of this building. The all vertical and the horizontal horses are supported by the slender and thin column. This is the plan. It is the slightly distorted square shape. The point you can see that this point you can see the each point is columns. The columns are placed to appear random. Based on the placement of these columns, the different spaces are created. In this project, I wanted to seek out the ambiguous space. The people will fill the whole space of the different 2,000 square meters in each place. It means, in this 2,000 square meters single space, the countless kind of the place is included. This is an enlarged part of the plan. You can see the number of the columns. The each column is a completely different the proportion and different shape and also different direction. There are 315 columns in this building, but the all proportion and the direction is completely different. So this is a detailed drawing of the 315 columns. Each column is a different direction, different proportion, and also different purpose of the structure, and also purpose of the space. This is a photograph of the entrance. From here, you can see the edge. A lot of edge of the columns, so you can see far away from this space. But from this place, you can see a lot of face of the column. So the many faces of columns give more impression of the closed space. Within this building, there are many ways like animal trails, and also sometimes we have the no column area. And also, this is a no columns area, but also looks a little bit closed atmosphere because there are a lot of columns face surface. Now, this is the area where the columns are crowded. This space is very looks narrow. The many spaces overlaps to make a one space. This is a plan of the furniture and the columns. The arrangement of the columns looks random, but it is strictly determined. For example, this is the load for cars, this is the office area, this is the workshop area, where is the no columns area, and also this is the entrance, and this is the load for the counter, and also this is the machine or something. The boundaries between these spaces are fuzzy and ambiguously. With this ambiguity, we are trying to create a new flexibility of the building. This is an enlarged plan. The column and the furniture are arranged in different directions. My feeling, the normal building, it's the direction of the inside of the space is defined by the structure of the building. For example, the direction of the structure is define the direction of the layout of the chairs. So normal building is structure decide the the direction of the each furniture. But this in this building is a no direction. The each direction is defined by the relationship with the each element. The skylights are like a sunlight filtering through the trees. It is atmosphere like being in the forest. The various areas and the spaces spread through this building like a landscape. Rather than make a space by the composition of the shape, but this space is made as if making a landscape. Each column looks like a wood. When we watch the inside from the outside, inside of this building looks like another outside space. This is a movie. We edited the film took by the 4 months by the put together on the short movie. We took this picture by the security camera. In this building, the same person is always walking the same way. This is a very narrow, the narrow in-between space. Nobody through this space, like a wall. But the reality, this is not a wall, so sometimes go through. So, and also that each person can probably walk straight, but they couldn't. This column is always touched by everybody. In this building, all of the furniture is always moving and then always make a new space. So they are making the barricade align the columns. Before, like this narrow space was like a wall, but in this case, like this narrow in-between space becomes the entrance of this private space. In this case, the old person is walking the same way. But this is also the same group, but in this case, it's nobody walking the same way. In this building, a lot of type of the space created by each person. The next project is project in the project of the Polytechnical Museum planning in the Moscow, Russia. This is a renovation and extension of the 18th century historical building. This is the original building. The total floor area is 40,000 square meters. It is a huge building, occupied one steep block. Even though it is 40,000 square meters, huge building. There is only one small public entrance here. As you can see from this picture, there are a lot of big one-way roads in Moscow, which is the character of this city. This is a big one-way road. These big wide roads make city district blocks. So because of those wide traffic, there are no crosswalk in this city. And the people are crossed through the underpass to reach the next block. So this building is fulfilled the one city block. So the only way to reach this building is from the underneath path. So for this reason, I think this building had a very unwelcome impression, even though a public facility. The task of this project is how we can change this negative, unwelcoming impression to the positive, friendly impression. That is our main concept for this building. This is the existing section drawing. The building had a 5 level above the ground. This is the ground level. There is 4 or 5 stories above from the above of the ground. And also, there is one basement floor in this building. The above the ground level are not bad condition. It could be repaired and improved by the small restorations. On the other hand, the basement condition is very bad. It needs a large restoration work. Therefore, above the ground level, we try to preserve the original condition as much as possible. On the other hand, in the basement level, apply the large renovation to create a new space. We sought to change existing basement floor into the new ground floor by digging down the ground, around the museum and reshape like a ball to let people into the building, like this. This is the existing ground level. And then we create a new landscape like this. And then existing basement floor becomes the new ground floor. By digging and reshaping the ground shape as smooth slab, the basement floor becomes the new ground level. So this original basement floor would be a new entrance space for this museum. As I explained, most of the people come to this existing museum from the underground path. So if the original basement floor turns into the ground floor, the circulation becomes more natural. This is the basement floor. This is the plan of the basement floor. Because it is a brick structure building, there are a lot of load-bearing brick walls to support the building. But as a result, the basement floor is very complex like a maze. We plan to open up this space as much as possible to use the new entrance space. We carefully research and remove the load-bearing brick wall as much as possible and create a huge colonnaded space like this. And this is the new basement plan after remove the structure load-bearing wall. We remove the brick wall as much as possible to create a huge colonnaded space for the entrance. Once the closed impression is taken out, the existing basement space becomes a huge open entrance space. The complicated existing entrance becomes a beautiful pattern drawing. When people come to this museum at the first time, they experience the fluid space of the countless brick columns. People can reach anywhere in this museum from this new big entrance area. This is the landscape plan of the plan with the landscapes of surrounding. The surrounding the slope becomes the new landscape. like this. The new ground floor with the surrounding lamp of the lamp becomes the new public space. The surrounding landscape fit it reformed to the bowl shape, and the beautiful colonnaded space of the basement are gently connected, and a huge public space can be created. New environment which is connected gradually inside to the outside is appeared. Through the tunnel under the white traffic, the new landscape of the museum park appear in front of you. This is a bird's eye perspective view. This is the existing elevation. The historical building in the elevation, proportion of the elevation is very important. We are thinking to change the proportion of the building like this. The existing ground level here, we create a new ground level here. So the building shape proportion, the shape of the elevation of the building proportion is completely become different. So I think the just making the new ground floor. So the impression of the old building is completely different. The important point is that without having any additional component in the existing building, this building will reverse as a completely new building by changing the structure concept and also concept of the level of the ground level. This is the perspective view from the north side of the museum. The gentle lamp, the people can reach to the new ground level. This is the view from the west side of the building. The curved landscape continues to the inside. The various vegetation are planted in the lamped landscape around the building. This is the winter. This is the in-between space of the inside and the outside landscape. And now the situation of the project is the construction period. So now the auto person digging the surrounding of the building. That this is the existing level of the ground. So you can see the people here. You can imagine the scale of the building. So this is become the new ground level, and then the building scale becomes more bigger. So this is the wall of the surrounding, and then this is the new proportion of the historical building. The inside of the building, the old existing wall were removed. And then in that case, we need to reinforce the element for each column. And also we need a new foundation under the structure. So now the all parts of the building supported by just only pillars. So we need a big foundation underneath the pillars. So now we are preparing to make a new foundation under each pillar. So now the building is a little bit floating by the steel, small steel columns. So, and then we making the new foundation here. So now a lot of space is open. The next project. This project is Japanese project. So the program is the house and restaurant. The location is the south part of Japan. The owner is the chef. The owner, the client is the chef of the restaurant. The client wants to have his restaurant and also his private house. This is the existing site condition. The site is located in the very countryside of Japan. The very comfortable, nice atmosphere, the client is, as I said, the restaurant owner. They want to have the kind of the old atmosphere of the space, because the he said the atmosphere of the new building is not so good for the dinner. So for example, the if the you can eat the dinner in the new shop in the new office building or something. So in that case, I think the he said the atmosphere is not good. He said the old atmosphere makes a more good, comfortable, and calm environment to eat the dinner. So I'm thinking the how to create like this old atmosphere by the making the building. So this is the section of the ground. So digging the soil and poured concrete, and also digging the soil around the inside of the building, and then make a new structure here. This is a very simple way, but also we are creating the kind of the natural atmosphere, like a cave. So I think the important point of the oldness, I was thinking the what is the oldness? The old architect always making the new building. The oldness is a kind of the mixture with the natural phenomenon and also the human actual thing. So I think the new building becomes the old by the window and the rainy and also time and also use. That is a kind of the natural atmosphere, a natural and also natural phenomenon. I try to mix with the natural phenomenon and also making the actual thing to make a old atmosphere. So this is the plan of the house and the restaurant. This is the entrance of the restaurant. Here is the kitchen and bar. This is the hall or restaurant. This is the preparing space. This is the courtyard. The three courtyards divide the restaurant and the private house. This is the entrance of the private house. This is the living and the kitchen and the bedroom and also bedroom. And this is the bathroom. So now this building is constructing. So this each shape of the space is defined by the models. So we trying to create like this model, and then we make a photo scan, and then make a data of the shape, and then make a drawing. This is the movie of the construction. This is the site. We planning the all shape of the all walls, but the constructor making the hole by the hand. So the little bit deciding from our planning and the real hole, shape of the real hole. This is a very narrow space. This is the kind of the landscape, but also this is the mold of the concrete. The depth of the hole is kind of the depth of the hole is like 3 meters. each soil condition is completely different from the depend on the position of the hole. So this is each condition of the floor is completely different, and then create a different atmosphere of each base of the building. And then also we are planning to pour the concrete the all holes of this landscape. But I don't want to make a different concrete class. So we trying to create pour the concrete on the just one day. The a lot of concrete is supplied from the outside. So this is a looks like a pond of the concrete. So it creates a new surface of the ground. All concrete fulfilled by the just one day, just 7 hours. And then the if concrete it becomes hard, the constructor becoming to make find a lot of space inside of the structure, in between the structure. This is the kind of the same way the archaeologist finding the space inside of the soil field. And also that we are planning to keep the surface of the soil surface of the structure. The in Japan we have the technique to repair the soil wall. The Japanese soil wall sometimes destroy and becoming the natural soil. So in that case, we can use the technique to repairing the destroying the destroying soil wall. So that we are planning to use the same technique to keep this surface of the building. This surface becomes the soil wall. And also the atmosphere of the inside of the space looks like a new building, but looks like existing structure or existing landscape or existing natural environment. So now we are making the inside space, and this building completed in this summer. So the each hole, the each like this window, the opening, put on we're planning to make a glass wall in between like this structure. So we are researching the shape of the each opening by the laser measuring, and then we are planning to cut the glass by the laser cutter. So we create a new wall in between the structure. This is the inside. This is the atmosphere of the inside. Okay. The next project is the kind of the weekend house in the diary of the China. This place is very nearby the Tibet. So this is a photograph of the site. It's a very beautiful place. We are planning to make weekend house, the 8 weekend house. Each weekend house has 400 to 500 square meters, and the total building area is around 5,000 square meters. So the diary is very famous for the locks. So this also this mountain is made by the locks, and then we can see the big valley here, and there is some small river here, and then site is around here. The site is here. This is river. There are many locks in the river. In this photograph, there's a little water, depend on the season, a lot of water flowing in between these locks. This is a very beautiful place, but recently, a lot of developer is coming to this place to make a new resort place. You know, the Chinese development speed is very rapid. So I think that this scenery cannot keep anymore. Probably after 2 years, that this scenery will change completely. So we decide to keep this. We decide to this beautiful scenery inside of new building, which we will plan. So the site is the lot of locks. It creates a lock landscape. We are finding a new space in between the existing lock layout, lock placement. Some place, of course, we replace the existing lock and a little bit move. And then, so we are finding a lot of space of in the existing landscape. Some place becomes the living, some place becomes the kitchen, and also main bedroom, the guest room or something. So I'm finding a lot of life space in between the existing landscape. And also we are trying to keep the existing environment inside of the building, because the surrounding environment becomes a different environment by the developers. So we are trying to keep the existing environment inside of the building, and also finding the new house space in between the existing landscape. This is the plan. This is the section. This site is the nearby the river, and also there is a very steep slopes. The length of the building is 300 meters. And also the difference of the height of here and here is 30 meters. And also the existing locks create a new house, new space for the house. But also same time, the existing lock becomes the load bearing structure to support the big roof. This is the view of the eye level. A lot of space become the new space of the house. Now sometimes the narrow in-between space, sometimes the very close space. We create a lot of space in between the existing landscape. And also, we are keeping the existing scenery inside of the building. Even if the surrounding condition of the environment will change, this scenery will keep in this building. So, this project also in the China's project. This is the church project, small chapel in between the mountains. So this is the site photograph. The site is here. The site is the bottom of the valley. So this is the existing small valley here. And then this is the site. So I create a new valley, which is larger than the gentle existing valley. And I intended to create the space of the church by the new valley. So the existing valley is not so big. So the height of the valley is just 30 meters or something. And also, I'm trying to make a new chapel space as a continuous space of the surrounding valley's environment. So I want to create a new valley inside of the building. This is the site plan. This is the site. This is a kind of small valley. So I want to create a new chapel, the continuous space, as a continuous space of the existing valley. So this is the new structure here. This is the existing valley, and this structure is a little bit higher than the existing valley. The height is 45 meters. The existing valley's height is 30 meters. The shape of the valley is narrow and high. The building is also very narrow and very high. The width of the entrance is just 1.3 meters, but the height is 45 meters. So very narrow and very high. Looks like same kind of space of the valley. But the playing space, the top of the building, is a little bit wider than the entrance. So a lot of sunlight come to the bottom of the space. This is a long section of the building. This is the entrance. This is a playing space. The roof, the light is come from the roof. But this area is very narrow, so the light is very difficult to come to the bottom. But this space is a little bit wider, so the light is come to the bottom. So this is the plan. This is the model. So you can access from this entrance to the inside. So the inside space around here is the brighter than the entrance. So the sunlight comes from the inside of the building. So this is the entrance space. The light is come from the inside. And then if you look up to the ceiling, the light is also come from the top of the building. So this is the playing space. This space is wider than the entrance, so a lot of sunlight fulfill the space. So this is the entrance direction. Also, the light is coming from the top of the ceiling. So the important point of this project is I want to create a scenery at the new space. So the mostly I think the scenery doesn't have the no shape and the no proportion and the no character of the space. So I think the scenery has the shape and the proportion. For example, the ballet is narrow and high, and the horizon scenery is very low and very wide. And also, the in-between space of the mountain, the little bit, how do you say, the small looks, feeling the small space. I think the scenery is a kind of the big space. So I want to create a new inside space as a scenery. So I think that for me, the proportion of the space is very important to make a building. This is also the kind of the theme of the proportion. So this is the old project that I made this project when I started my office. So this project is the proportion of the structure is very important. So this is a large table for some exhibition. In this project, I was thinking to make a large table as if I was making a small architecture. Not just making furniture, rather I wanted to make some new space and scenery from the table. It is a table as large as architecture and as thin as a paper craft. The length of this structure is 9.5 meters, and the width is 2.6 meters, and the height is 1.1 meters. It is quite larger than normal table. However, the thickness of the table is just 3 millimeters, like a thin paper. It is as if piece of the paper is floating in the air. On this paper thin tabletop, many things are arranged like a landscape. This is a picture from below. I think the shape of the table is looks like architecture. I feel the table legs it looks like a column, and the big tabletops it looks like a big roof. The shape of the table is a very pure form of architecture. I believe the table is a very pure architecture. If that is the case, I thought table could be designed like an architecture. This is a drawing of the elevations. It looks like a single drawing, but there is some proportion. This is the leg, this is the tabletop and the legs. Because of the such thin proportions, anyone can see this tabletop will be bent like this. Then, what would be good if we do design and structure analysis like architecture? By doing it like that, we can know how much it bend like this, and also we can understand the precise shape of the bending. If we know the shape of the bending, the rest is very simple. In other words, we should bend it in the opposite direction beforehand, like this. And then if we do this, when put it on the floor, the gravity, like this shape, make it flat. But this table is made of the aluminum, and itself weight around 700 kilograms. So, and also, but this table is an extremely thin proportion. It means that it does not bend normally. This table is bend a lot, like this. Finally, this table bend 1.5 rotation like this in the calculation. So this is the original shape of the table. This is the legs. This legs also wrapped like a banana nuts, and also the tabletop curved 1.5 rotation. This is the original shape of the table. This is a kind of the result of the structure analysis of many load conditions. the curvature of the bending was calculated like this condition. From the start, this table is bent in the opposite direction. When table put of this shape is put on the floor, gravity makes it flat. This is a photograph of the bending in the factory. The amount of the curvature varies by the location. The material is aluminum. This is a part of the tabletop, which is made a curvature of the 1.5 rotation like this, and put the legs here like this. The table becomes flat by itself weight. From the side, it looks like many things are lined up on the thread. It seems like a table melts into the space. And emphasize the small object, it makes a new scenery with a lot of small objects. This table is shape is a normal table, but the proportion is completely different from the normal table. So this proportion creates a new space. And also, this table is very heavy, but if touch the table, the table it creates a waving. So the small touch and the table sways like a paper on the water. The table of the structure, soft like a water surface, makes the landscape. This is a beautiful landscape which appears on the surface like a water. Through this project, I want to think about some kind of the new possibility of the architectural space by seeking out the new proportion of the architectural structure. So next project is a kind of the same theme. This is also the theme is the proportion of the structure and the space. This project is the multi-purpose hall in the university, same as the kite workshop. The required program was the party hall, rainy weather practice ground, half outside plaza, and the barbecue space. It is a program with a mix with the inside and outside factors. I think of making this program as a one architecture. This is the site the university site drawing. This is the whole site of the university. This is the kite workshop, as I explained before. So this is the playground. The new site is one of the site of the playground here. Very bigger than the kite workshop. This is the plan drawing. The length of the width of the building is 110 meters. And also the depth of the building is 17 meters. This is and also the inside of the building is no columns. Just a wall here. The inside is no common space. The composition of the building is like this, very simple, just a huge single space. This is the roof plan drawing. It is an extremely huge roof surface, which is same size as the plan, 100 meters here and 70 meters here. This large roof is made out of the one piece of metal plate. That is 12 millimeters, like this very thin thickness of the one steel big plate here. There are various sides of opening in this huge metal plate. The glass is not inserted in this opening, so rain and wind would come into the room from this opening. This large single space becomes a huge semi-outdoor space. This is the section. This is the roof here. This is the floor. The inside of the building is no column. The span is 110 meters, but all the structure is supported by the surrounding wall here and here. And this big roof is made by the huge one seat of the steel plate. The thickness of this roof is just the 1.2 centimeters. And the height of the inside space is just 2.3 meters. This is the thin and the wide space. So the like this, the ultra thin single space. So I think that even though that this roof is kind of the mega structure, spanning the 110 meters. But the thickness of the roof is just 1.2 centimeters. This is a super delicate megastructure. So big and the low and the big, and the large and the very thin. Now, let's think about the space of the Earth where we live. This is a photograph from the outside of the Earth. You can see the cloud and ground. We are living the ultra-thin space between cloud like a lace, the light land like a paper. We call this ultra-thin space scenery. So I'm trying to create the architecture at the same proportion of the scenery. This is a picture of the horizon. We are living like this thin proportion space. This is a photograph of the model from the side. The building elevation is a very extremely thin. The site for building is on the part of the campus of the university. It is located where the ground level is lower than the rest of the campus. So this big roof is the first thing that visitors see. This is a photograph looking into the inside of the building. The floor and the ceiling have a subtle curvature like this here. So far in the distance looks like a horizon. You can see the wall. In the far way, the ceiling and the floor making the one horizon here. I think it is ceiling like a sky and the floor like us, making the one horizon inside of the building. This is the picture of the horizon again. We are living like this thin proportion of the space. In this huge scenery, some place bright sunlight comes in, even though most of the area is dark. And in this photograph, certain area it rains, even though most of the area is not rain. Our building is same as this. This is a photograph of the interior space. Some place become the bright, some place become the dark, and some place become the rain, some place become the waterfall, like in the rainy day. This is the interior space, but depend on the weather condition. The condition of the atmosphere of the inside space becomes completely different. By planning this building, we think of making a new scenery inside of the university. In other words, rather than go to the school, the student will come to this building as if they traveling to the another world. This is the photograph of the test of the structure. The very difficult to make a big one sheet of the steel plate. So now we are testing a lot. So now we are making try to create how we can make a flat big one sheet of the steel plate. This is the detail section. This is the wall, and this wall supports the whole structure of the roof, like this. And then the shape of the floor is following the shape of the roof, like this. So the floor and the roof little bit have some curvature. So in the far away, there is some big horizon here. And then this wall supported by the big foundation of the surrounding. Inside of the building is no structure here. Just the surrounding the building, the structure is just the surrounding of the building. Inside of the building is no structure. So now we are preparing to construct this building. So probably so we can start the construction in this summer and then complete next year. The final project, this is a kind of the installation of the museum. And this was the exhibit in the group show at the Art Museum of Tokyo in 2007. The space I was given was large with a ceiling height of 20 meters. It was largest space there, so I want to create something like a scenery rather than just put on the object. This is a sketch for the exhibition. So the wishing in the giant square space, I thought of floating a giant metal mass. It is a square balloon made of the hard metal. It's about as large as a five-story building. It weighs around 1 ton. By filling the mass with helium gas, it floats around the space like a balloon, like this. A heavy and hard body without connected to anything floats in the space. I was thinking of making a very abstract cloud in this space. This is a photograph of the hole. This is the site. Because it is about as large as a five-story building, it was constructed like architecture, a big crane into the museum to assemble it like this. It was constructed by the jacking it up little by little. The inside structure is truss structure, and also the like this panel that prevent the horizontal holes. This is the section. This is the movie. So the big mass, which is 1 ton, around the five-story building, is floating slowly around in the atrium. The square metal body is filled with helium gas, so buoyancy cancels the self-weight without strings attached to it. So because with no strings attached to it, that slowly drift about bumping into the wall and the floor. I didn't necessarily want to make this square object. I wanted to make a space between this object and the existing wall and the floor. This space can sometimes be narrow, wide, tall, low, triangular, or square. Hour by hour, like the sky changing, the form of this space changes too. Through all projects, I'm seeking the new environment which never exists in the natural world by making the new architecture. I want to try seeking the new abstraction of the nature by creating the new actual environment from the new architecture. Thank you.